This is atheism in a nutshell. You say there's a God. I say, can you prove that? You say no. I say, I don't believe you then. Mm-hmm. So you believe in one God, I assume?
In three persons, but go ahead.
Okay, so you believe... Okay. Mm-hmm. So, but there are about 3,000 to choose from that have been, you know, people who believe in...
I've done some reading, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So basically, you believe in... You deny one less God than I do. You don't believe in 2,999 gods, uh-huh. And I don't believe in just one more.
Right. Do you ever have a feeling of great gratitude for existence?
Of course.
I know the
chances are billions to one that I am on this planet as me and never will be again.
And I know I can't convince you that there is a God, nor do I really want to convince you there's a God, but
no.
I can only explain my experience, which is that I have a strong desire to direct that gratitude toward something or someone.
Of course.
And that thing is God.
We're mortal. We want to make sense of nature and science. And it's too unfathomable that everything in the universe was once crunched into something smaller than an atom.
But you don't know that.
Well...
You're just believing Stephen Hawking, and that's a matter of faith in his abilities.
Yeah, yes.
You don't know it yourself. You're accepting that because someone told you.
Yeah, well... But science is constantly proved all the time. You see, if we take something like any fiction, in any holy book, in any other fiction,
yeah.
and destroyed it,
yeah.
okay, in 1,000 years' time, that wouldn't come back just as it was.
Yes.
Whereas if we took every science book,
yes.
right, and every fact, and destroyed them all, in 1,000 years, they'd all be back, because all the same tests would be the same result.
That's good.